Hey everybody, this is Brijesh here and you are watching CABA Infoventry. In my earlier video, I shared with you the legal and important point for dismissal of check bounce case against you by the court, that is legal liability, with the help of various examples for your easy understanding. Now, I am going to share with you this in detail with some more examples so that you can understand this properly and apply to your check bounce case in defense in order to win the case successfully. Keep watching this video till end in order to get the full benefit out of this video. Now, for example, X, the complainant, has filed a case against Y, the accused, for dishonor of check in the court. X has complained that he has given a cash loan of rupees 15 lakh to Y, and he, that is Y, gave him that check for return of that cash loan which has bounced or dishonored, and therefore he filed a case against him, Y, for dishonor of check. Now, just presume that you, that is Y, is the accused for this dishonor of check, and then what probable defense are available with you? This may be that by way of documentary evidence, you can prove the financial capacity of X during the course of trial before the court, that X never had so much money in his bank account. Or you may request the court that X should be ordered to produce his income tax return for last 5 years before the court, which will prove that what X is stating is highly improbable, that he has given a loan of rupees 15 lakh to Y because he never had so much money in his bank account and he was filing his income tax return of rupees 1 lakh only every year, then how he can give a loan of rupees 15 lakh to Y? Further, on checking the bank statement of X, if no withdrawal of rupees 15 lakh is made by him, then you can doubt this fact to the knowledge of the court that it is clear that he never withdrew rupees 15 lakh from his bank account. Also, X, who is claiming that he has given a loan of rupees 15 lakh to Y, then it should be seen that what is his profession or business or occupation. If he is either unemployed, or he is running a small tuition center, or he is a mechanic, or he is having a small general merchant shop, then a person having this type of a small profession or business or occupation who cannot earn even rupees 15 lakh, what to talk about of saving rupees 15 lakh, then how he can give loan of rupees 15 lakh to Y? This fact should be brought to the knowledge of the court. If a doubt is created in the mind of the court that X never had rupees 15 lakh at any point of time, and also his financial position is not so that he can advance rupees 15 lakh to anybody, and he is not earning and saving that much of the money, and there is no concrete evidence, that is documentary evidence, in the possession of X which can prove that X would have given rupees 15 lakh to Y as loan, then the probability of winning the case will tilt in your favor, and you can win this case on this ground alone, stating that whatever check you gave to X, that was not for discharge of your legal liability, and that you never took the loan of rupees 15 lakh from X. Now let us presume that what could be the reverse scenario in this case. The reverse could be that X has taken the loan from you. For example, X filed a case against you. However, the fact was that you advanced money to X in the form of a loan for which you issued a check to X. Later on, after issuing the check to X, you change your mind because you got the information from your reliable sources that X is not an honest person and he has not returned the money taken on loan from the market from other persons in the past, and therefore you decided that you will not give loan to X. Due to the reason of not giving the loan to X by you, dishonesty came into the mind of X, and he got that check dishonored which was given by you to X as loan. Then after X made a bogus case against you that X had given loan in cash to you and you were returning that loan by way of this check which you issued, and X got that check dishonored. In this transaction, there was no legal liability on you towards X. I hope now you could understand this case properly and apply to the facts of your case and win the check bouncing case. Negotiable Instrument Act clearly prescribes that if a check is given for discharge of legal liability, then only it is an offense under this act and not otherwise. If you have given a check for any other purpose to a person and that is not for discharge of your legal liability which got bounced, then that is not an offense under Negotiable Instrument Act. Now I will share with you another example to bring more clarity on this issue. There is a firm that is Total Dishonest Limited, and Mr. Honest gave a check to that firm which got bounced. Now, Total Dishonest Limited filed a case for recovery of the amount of bounced check in the court against Mr. Honest, stating before the court that Total Dishonest Limited had given a loan to Mr. Honest and Mr. Honest gave that check in repayment of that loan which got bounced. Now presume that you are Mr. Honest in this case. Now you can request the court that the firm Total Dishonest Limited should be ordered to produce its balance sheet, profit and loss account and financials before the court. Since Total Dishonest Limited is a legal entity, and if it gives a loan to anybody, then it should naturally be shown in its books of accounts and financials, meaning thereby that this loan will be shown in its financials as a loan given to you as recoverable amount. If there is no outstanding amount appearing in against you in its financials or in its balance sheet, then there will be a doubt created in the mind of the court that how Total Dishonest Limited can give a loan which has not been shown in its financials under loan and advances. If doubt is created in the mind of the court, then it will be in your favor that is accused against whom the complaint has been filed by Total Dishonest Limited. Now I will share with you another example which will bring more clarity in this regard. Say for example, you have given a check to a person or a trader for the purchase of certain goods. When you went to the shop or showroom of that trader, then he showed you the sample of the goods which you approved that okay, this particular quality of product you will be purchasing, say for example Sony TV. You were satisfied with that sample and then you issued a check for purchase of those Sony TV. But once you received in actual those goods, then you found that those goods were completely different. Their quality was inferior and they were not conforming to the sample which you approved for purchase from that person. Or the product supplied by that person to you is completely of the different model than what you approved for purchase at the time of order, or the brand was entirely different. Say it was LG and not Sony. Hence, whatever terms you have agreed for the purchase of product at the time of placing the order were not fully complied with and adhered to by the supplier, maybe its quality, maybe its brand or some other parameters. Once you receive the gold supplied by the supplier in actual, then you find it entirely different. Then you instruct your banker to stop payment of the check. Once you stop payment of the check, then the check get bounced. Once check get bounced, then the supplier files a suit against you in the court for check bounce and for recovery of that amount. In this case, because the contract was done by the supplier by misrepresentation, by false promise, therefore you should return the goods to the supplier and you can cancel your order and there will be no legal liability upon you for this check bounce. There will be no legal liability upon you to pay the amount to that supplier for this bounce check, because that person has sold you goods by fraud, by misrepresentation. He has sold the goods to you by fraud, forgery, misrepresentation, false representation, and that he has obtained the check by fraud, forgery, misrepresentation or false representation. In this case, you will be acquitted and there will be no liability upon you for check bounce. In my next video, I will be sharing with you some more examples for your easy understanding that what is your legal liability as per Negotiable Instrument Act, so that you can win the check dishonor case against you in the court. Stay safe and healthy. Bye-bye.